Sophie, how did the dress rehearsal go?
Yes, it went really well, thank you, sir.
I must congratulate you on being accepted for order next year.
Thank you. Well, I'm glad the auditions are over and now I can concentrate on the play.
Juliet is a challenging role, but I'm sure that you're going to be superb at it.
Well, I'm really looking forward to the performance.
I'll be there on the last night, along with the governess.
Introduce them to my parents?
Of course I know your mother, because she works here. But your father, I've never met him. He's never been at any parents' evening.
Well, yes, he is very busy, you know, global business and all that, but I'm sure he will be there on the last night.
I'll look forward to meeting him. Well done, and I'll see you on Friday.
Yes, yes, Friday, sir. Even if you fail.
Oh, terrific news about Raga!
You must be so excited. I can't wait to see you playing Juliet next week.
I can see your name in lights one day. Star of film,
screen, and television.
Well, steady on, girls. It's just a school play.
It's not just a school play. You're the leading lady. You're Juliet.
And the gorgeous Gary Palmer is Romeo. Wow, I'm so jealous. The gorgeous, the heartthrob of the school, Gary Palmer. And you
kiss him! Girls, it's nothing, it's just acting.
Just acting? You know you fancy him.
I do not!
Yes, you do. And you know he's got the hots for you.
Girls, stop it now. It's just acting.
That kiss will not be acting. That will be for real.
It will not!
Scene. It'll be like a dream.
Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo?
What light through yonder window breaks? It is the east, and Juliet is the sun.
Oh, look, girls, I can't hang around all day. This is ridiculous. I'm going to the library to pick up some books from my mum.
Hiya, Sue.
Why? Look who's walking this way.
Gary, the heartthrob Palmer.
Oh, stop it, girls. You're so embarrassing.
Gary, you were great last night.
Thanks. I just do my best.
Doesn't he always, Sophie?
Well, we all do. And the headmaster said he really enjoyed the show last night.
Yeah, I know. He also had a word with me.
He's going on the last Friday and he wants to meet my parents after the show.
But, Sophie, we've never seen
you. So I've got to go now. I've got to go and pick up some books, surprisingly. See you later.
Bye. Bye.
I have to go now, girls. See you later.
Bye!
Hi, Mum. I've just come to pick up my books.
I hear the rehearsal went very well last night.
Well, it was okay. We had a few mistakes, but I'm sure it'll be all right another night.
I'm looking forward to seeing it.
Oh, but you know I get nervous when I know you're in the audience.
Oh, you'll be fine, darling. I'm so proud of you.
Oh, thanks, Mum. I'll try my best.
I know you will, and I hear the headmaster and governors are attending on the last night. It's such an honour.
Well, no pressure then. Well, I've got to go now. It's registration. So, see you later.
We've gone well.
Gary, come on now, ladies. Let's settle down, please. We need to do the register. Come on.
We're all here, sir.
Great, that's fantastic. That makes my job a lot easier, girls. Okay, thanks very much. Just one thing before we go to lessons. I've got a message here. You need to have your tickets sorted out for Romeo and Juliet next week. Okay, and I'm sure that Gary and Sophie here are going to make the best Romeo and Juliet that we've seen in this school forever.
Well, how long's forever, sir?
Ah, forever. Well, I'm proud to say that I've been at this school now for 30 years.
So did you teach William Wilberforce then, sir?
Well, you might not believe it, but I actually did teach him. And I do remember him because he failed his French.
Oh, God, that is so funny.
You should be a French teacher, you should be a comedian.
Well, maybe a clown.
You got the face for it.
Come on, Liz, you're going to be happy, you get out now, come on. You'll be late for French.
Oh, wait, girls, wait a minute.
What do you want?
I've got a secret I've got to share with you.
A secret? You know it's safe with us.
Well, I can't tell you right now, but meet me at the pavilion at lunchtime.
Okay. Oh, brilliant.
I can't wait.
So, what's the secret all about?
Well, you know the headmaster wants to see my parents on Friday after the show?
Yes.
And you know my father's never been to a parents' evening?
Yeah, he's always been away on business.
Well, not quite.
Not quite?
Well, it's like this. Now, what I'm going to tell you is top secret.
We're listening.
Well, the truth is, my mum isn't married.
But the headmaster wants to see your parents after the show.
I know, it's awkward.
So what excuse are you going to make?
Well, there'll be no excusing. Now, I said mum wasn't married, but I found her old diary. By all accounts, she wasn't without her admirers.
Ooh, sounds interesting. Tell us more.
Dad is coming to the play.
You mean we'll finally get to see your father at last?
Well, my mother had a summer romance, and he left before realising that she was expecting.
What?
Well, this diary is from the year she was pregnant with me.
Oh. Well,
hang on!
We danced by a fire, we kissed by a fire, and dot, dot, dot.
What's dot, dot, dot?
Well, you know, that's what they did in the old days. He's the one, I know he is. I've never felt like this before.
Honey, honey, how you thrill me. Honey, honey. Honey, honey, nearly kill me. Honey, honey, I'd heard about you before. I wanted to know some more. And now I'm all on me, you're a machine. Oh, you make me dizzy. Honey, honey, let me feel it. Honey, honey. Don't conceal it, honey, honey. The way that you kiss goodnight,
the way that you kiss goodnight,
the way that you hold me tight,
the way that you hold me tight.
You tell me I want to see when you do your thing.
So, Sam's your father.
Well, August the 4th, what a night. Bill arrives on his scooter and takes me to Scarborough for the evening.
Oh my God! Stop! Stop.
August the 11th, Harry turns up in a sports car. I offer to show him around the area. Well, one thing led to another, and...
Dot, dot, dot!
Girls, what are you getting so excited about?
Oh, it's nothing.
Girl thing. Just having fun.
Total stranger inviting them to the school play. They think mother sent the invites.
They think your mother sent the invites?
With what's in that diary, no wonder they all said yes.
Honey, honey, nearly kill me. Honey, honey, I heard about you before. I wanted to know some more. And now
know what they mean. You're a love machine.
Hi, Gary.
Are you nervous for tonight, Gary?
Petrified, but I'm ready for the challenge. It's no different to any other night.
And I'm sure you can't wait to kiss Sophie again.
Oh, girls, it's just acting.
Perhaps you need some more practice, Gary. I'm sure we can help.
Pity, but I'm in a rush, girls.
Bye, Gary.
Be quiet, girls. This is a library.
We were just trying to help Gary with the finer points of his line.
I'm sure he'll be all right tonight without your help.
Hi, Sophie. You prepared for the final performance?
Oh, a few butterflies, but I'll be okay.
I've invited two of my old girlfriends tonight to watch the performance.
You've invited two of your old friends?
Yes, darling, is that all right?
Oh, yes. Can't wait to see them.
Right, I must get my jobs done because they'll be arriving any minute.
Have you told your mum about the invites yet?
No, this was going to be a surprise.
Surprise? She'll kill you when she finds out.
I just feel like there's a part of me missing. Yeah. But when I meet my dad, everything's going to fall into place.
Aww. Well, Donna's come up in the world, hasn't she? A private school.
It's a long way from Roseville Secondary Modern.
How times have changed.
And looks.
Speak for yourself. I'm still as gorgeous as when I was 18.
In your head.
Thank you. I'd have you know that these looks are all natural, unlike yours.
I'll have you know it cost a fortune to look this good.
Well, I can tell you, you were robbed.
Excuse me, young lady.
Yes, can I help you?
Yes, we're looking for Donna.
Donna? The librarian's called Donna. Could that be her?
Is she ravishing, young and drop-dead gorgeous?
Well, I wouldn't really like to say.
Well, she was 20 years ago, but time does take its toll. Speak for yourself, darling.
Well, Donna's the librarian. And she's about your age.
You mean just turned 30?
Well, if you say so. Anyway, the library's at the end of the corridor. I'll take you there.
This is the library. Where is she?
Can you be quiet down there?
That sounds like Donna.
Well, look at what the cat's brought in!
For one night only, Donna and the Dynamos!
You look fantastic!
That should do, it's cost a fortune! And this is completely natural.
Well, I'll stick to surgery.
I'm glad you've come. We've got so much to talk about.
Working here must be great. All those young male teachers. You got any spare?
Pass them my way.
Sorry, girls. I've got no time for dating.
What? Donna, the girl who had them crawling all over her, has gone into retirement?
Donna and the Dynamos, that host of men, is completely unthinkable.
Girls, 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 I've got no time to think about men. I've got school fees to pay, and now she's going to RADA, it's going to be so much more difficult.
Donna, there's always time for men.
Can I help you?
Hello, I'm here for the play.
Well, you're a bit early. It's not on till this evening.
I didn't have any idea what time it started. It didn't say on the invite. An old friend. It came completely out of the blue. She wants me to see her daughter playing Juliet.
Ah, that must be Donna that invited you, yes?
Yes, Donna. I can't wait to see her again.
Well, if you'd like to take a seat, I'll contact her shortly.
I'm in the right place, sweetheart.
Well, you're in Pocklington School.
Yeah, Pocklington School. Just point me in the direction of the theatre.
Oh, you're here for the play.
That's what it says.
Oh, were you invited by Donna, by any chance?
I sure was. I hope she's still as ravishing. I haven't seen her in years.
Well, I'm sure you won't be disappointed. Please take a seat over there.
Right. Are you a potential parent?
No, I'm here to see the play.
Me too. Looks like we're a bit early.
Lost?
Oh, not now that I've found you. Where have you been most of my life?
Most of your life? I haven't even been around.
Ooh, wow. Just think what you've been missing.
Are you here for the play?
Well, I got an invite.
From Donna, I presume?
Well, I like a girl who can read my mind.
I can. And the next answer is no.
Story of my life. Opportunities missed.
You're a little early. If you wait over there, I'll give her a ring.
I wanted to give her a ring once. Ooh. Those were the days. Hi, I'm here to see the play.
Hi, same reason, here to see the play.
Also, here to see the play.
Fancy that.
Reception here, is it possible to speak to Donna?
Hi Anna, it's Sophie. Yeah, Mum's not here at the moment, do you want to leave a message?
There are three men in reception who she has invited to the play, but they've turned up early.
What, there are three men, you said?
Yes, they all have invites.
You're not going to believe this. The invites worked and they're all in reception.
So what are you going to do?
Mum has not got to see them. I've got a plan.
Well, Mum left a message to say that if anybody arrived early, they need to be given a tour of the school.
Can you send me some sixth formers?
Okay, I'll do it right away. Thank you.
Well, what's your plan?
The plan is, you go down to reception, take them to the pavilion and keep them well out of the way.
Great!
We're on our way!
Excellent.
Hi, we've been sent by Donna to pick up her visitors. Apparently you're to take them on a tour of the school. We'll look after them.
Hello. I'm Sam.
Hi, my name's Judy.
Hi, Bill.
Hi, I'm Catherine.
Hi, I'm Harry, but my lady friends call me H.
I'm Sheena.
Hello, Sheena.
Hi. Shall we take them on a tour of the school then?
I think so. Follow us.
Sophie, have there been any messages? No, Mum's been really quiet.
So this is a talented daughter we've heard so much about.
She looks so like you when you were that age.
Hey, your mother was a real raver at your age.
Too much information, girls.
Could you introduce us?
Sophie, this is Rose.
I'll fill you in later on our teenage years.
And this is Tanya.
I wish I was your age. The odd bit of surgery is helping, though. If you say so.
Well, it was lovely to meet you. I've got to go to lessons, though. I'll see you later. See you.
She's so beautiful. But you never told us who the father was.
That'll have to wait. This is not the place. Anyway, what about the men in your lives?
I'm still looking for Mr. Wright, and I'm enjoying sampling all the merchandise along the way. Life is for enjoying, and I'm going to enjoy every minute. I couldn't agree more. Life's like a box of chocolates. One minute you've got a nutty one, and the next you go for the soft centre.
Well, I wish I even had time to sample a boiled sweet. But with the responsibilities of this job and bringing up Sophie on my own, I don't have time for men at all.
Hang around with us, baby, and we'll change your situation.
Well, let's get tonight over first. Oh gosh, I forgot to pick up the tickets. You go and have a look around the theatre and I'll meet you over there.
Sounds like a good idea.
yourselves down, make yourselves at home and refresh yourselves before the play tonight.
What a great idea. I think I could do with a wash and brush up.
Not bad. Accommodation and a cricket pitch. What could be sweeter?
Thanks, girls, for your help. We'll just put our feet up and relax.
Okay, bye then. See you tonight.
See you tonight.
Bye.
Look forward to it.
Look forward to that.
Strange we never bumped into each other all those years ago.
Yeah, Donna was popular back in the 70s. Wonder what she looks like now.
Well, I bet she's as gorgeous as she was back then.
Hi, I've come to pick up my tickets for tonight's performance. Sure, here they are. How are your guests getting on?
Guests?
Yes, the three men. The girls took on tour.
Three men?
Yes. They all knew you from years ago. They all had invites.
Years ago? Oh yes, I sent the invites. I expect they're on a tour still.
They should be about finished by now.
I'll go and catch up with them.
Are they alright?
You're telling me they're alright.
Steady on, they're old enough to be your father.
No, they're old enough to be your father.
Aren't you curious to find out which one is your father?
Yes, I'll see you later. Make up some excuse why I'm not in class.
Okay.
Okay, we'll wait.
Everything alright?
Fine, we're here for the play. I'm Sam, hi.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, I'm Bill.
Bill.
Hi, I'm Harry.
Hi, Harry.
Are you Donna's daughter?
Yes.
I thought you looked familiar. So you're Sophie?
Yes.
You've got your mother's good looks.
Can you take us to see your mother?
Yes. I mean, no.
You mean we've come all this way and we're not going to get to see your mother?
Well, the truth is, I sent the invites.
You sent them?
Yeah, well, she's always talking about you, so I thought I'd invite you as a bit of a surprise.
This could be embarrassing. The last time I saw her, she said she never wanted to see me again.
Oh, please, that was a long time ago. It would mean so much to me.
Time's a great healer. Don't you worry, we'll be there tonight.
Ooh, I'd like to see Donna again. A great deal of water has flowed under the bridge since we last met.
Well, I've got to go, but I'll see you later. I'll see you later tonight.
It'll be difficult for me tonight, but seeing you will give me the strength to face you.
Bye.
I was cheated by you, and I think you know when. So I made up my mind, it must come to an end. Look at me now, will I ever learn? I don't know how, but I suddenly lose control. There's a fire within my soul. Just one look and I can hear a bell ring. One more look and I forget everything. Mamma mia, here I go again. My, my, how can I resist you? Mamma mia, does it show again? My, my, just how much I've missed you. Yes, I've been broken hearted, blue since the day we parted. Why did I ever let you go? Mamma mia, now I really know. My, my, I should not let you go.
You always knew how to make an entrance.
I'd better be dreaming. You'd better not be here.
Well, we are all here, and you haven't changed.
Bill Anderson, you were always a flatterer.
You probably didn't recognise me. My hair's changed a bit.
Harry Bright, with that cheeky look, you haven't changed a bit either. What are you all doing here?
Just passing by. We're three complete strangers, washed up by the tide of time.
So you don't know each other?
No, we've never met before.
I'd like all three of you to catch the next tide out of here.
If that's what you want, Donna, we'll oblige.
I don't know what I want. It's my daughter's play tonight and that's all I can think about.
It appears we're not wanted.
She always was unsure of herself.
I don't know what to say.
Tell you what, let's just relax and get ready for the play tonight.
Thank you.
did before. It's her dad.
Whose dad?
It's Sophie's dad. Don't you remember how I told you all those years ago about being in love with Sam?
You said he was the one.
It didn't last. He wanted to go around the world and I didn't. Then there were two others not long after, along with Sophie.
You mean one of them's Sophie's dad?
I know that Sam's the one.
So what's the problem?
The problem is that they're all in school and someone's invited them to the play and I don't know who.
Mum, I invited them.
Sophie, why did you do it?
Well, the headmaster wants to meet my parents after the show and I finally want to know who my father is.
And how did you find their names?
Well, I must confess, I looked in your old diary.
I hope there's nothing in there about me. It could be embarrassing.
We were foxy ladies then.
And now I'm washed out. There haven't been men on my agenda for years.
Oh, don't be like that, Mum. You're fabulous. And now it's time to reignite an old flame.
Whatever happened to Donna, the rock chick supremo?
I grew up.
Well, grow back down again.
My mother's name was Rose.
And I bet you say that to all the girls.
Yes, my mother's names have been Margaret, Julie, Rachel and Donna over the years.
So you knew Donna?
Yes, for a few rapturous moments in the 70s.
And now do you have any luggage in your life?
No, I'm a free agent, a travelling light.
Like myself, just going where the wind takes you.
Sounds interesting.
Come on, let's go see the play.
Hi.
Hi. I'm Tanya, an old friend of Donna's.
Hey, less of the old. You do yourself an injustice.
I'm Harry, by the way.
You knew Donna some years ago?
Yes. A brief romantic interlude in my life.
And now?
And now I'm looking for the right woman to settle down with.
Looking for the right woman? Let's go inside and talk.
What are you doing here, Sam?
You should ask Sophie. She invited me.
You are her guest, so watch the play and go like you did before.
I went in search of adventure all those years ago. You were invited, but you declined.
Perhaps I wanted to be independent and follow my own dream.
So we both went our own ways, but haven't we both neglected Sophie's needs?
Neglected Sophie? I've struggled to pay her school bills. I provided her with everything I possibly could.
Except?
Except what?
Except a father.
I've managed so far. I'm free, I'm single, and it's great.
Where are those happy days? They seem so hard to find. I tried to reach for you, but you have closed your mind. Whatever happened to our love? I wish I understood. It used to be so nice, it used to be so good. So when you're near me, darling, can't you hear me? S.O.S. The love you gave me, nothing else can save me. S.O.S. When you're gone, how can I even try to go on? When you're gone, though I try, how can I carry on?
You seem so far away, though you are standing. You made me feel alive, but something died, I fear. I really tried to make it out. I wish I understood. What happened to our love? It used to be so good.
So when you're near me, darling, can't you hear me? S.O.S. The love you gave me, nothing else can save me. S.O.S. When you're gone, how can I even try to go on? When you're gone, though I try, how can I carry on? So when you're near me, darling, can't you hear me? S.O.S.
I have a dream.
You gave me, nothing else can save me. S.O.S.
To see
when you're gone,
to help
how can
me call
I even try to go on
with anything?
When you're gone, though I try,
if you
how
see
can
the
I carry on?
All the
when you're gone, how can I even try
you
to
can
go
take
on?
The future.
When you're gone, how
oh,
can
I
even try to go on?
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and boys and girls. I'm sure that we'll all agree that we've just witnessed a most magnificent production of Romeo and Juliet. Normally, I would not like to single out one pupil in any performance, but I do think I should mention Sophie, who played Juliet this evening, and congratulate her on her place at RADA, the first time for any pupil from Pocklington. I would like Sophie's mother, Donna, with her husband to join me on stage. I'm sure they would like to say a few words. There appears to be some confusion.
the confusion, Headmaster, is because I'm not married.
I'm still a little bit confused.
Well, sorry, Headmaster. You wanted to know who my father was, so here he is in triplicate.
Well, it's great meeting you all.
You could say I have a third of an interest in Sophie. And I have another third.
And I suppose I have a third too.
You wait years to meet Sophie's father, and then three come along at once.
I'll clear up your confusion, Headmaster. Sophie, Sam's your father.
I knew it! Why didn't you just marry him?
Well,
Donna, I think I should explain. Perhaps at the time we weren't ready, but I've loved you all these years.
Now you tell me!
Come on, Donna, it's only for the rest of your life.
I feel like I win when I lose.
my Waterloo.